So it's time for another electrician's tool review. Gary, what have you got for us today?
We've got the UNIFOX cable tie tool from Pheonix Contact.
Take all the frogs, Fox.
It's Fox, I think.
Well, let's let the fox out of the hole, Gary. What does it actually do?
It pulls the cable tie to the correct tensile strength, we'll come to that in a minute, and cuts it super clean, because I'm sure before we've run our hands along a basket or a cable tray, found a tie wrap with a sharp edge, nicked our fingers with it, Gordon. Do you agree?
Yeah, could do. Well, I don't see what the problem is. You know, normally a cable tie, you fasten them around.
Yeah.
Pull. There we go.
Yeah, and there it is. There's the culprit that I've had many a moment on just there. And a cut finger, cut hand, cut palm. Thank you very much, Gordon. I found the culprit.
All right, okay. Well, sure it's there, but yeah, okay. And this, this one. But yeah, this is...
That's where the tensile strength comes in, Gordon. Believe it or not, when you look on a packet of cable ties or you look on their data sheet, they actually have a maximum, it's usually in kilograms, strength that you can pull those cable ties. Okay. And this bit of kit here will allow us to set that for each of the tie, let's call them tie wraps maybe, tie wraps that we set. Agreed?
Cable ties,
tie wraps, whatever we're going with. Okay.
There we go. Okay, so I'll put this around here.
Let's have a little look then, closer look. Okay, yeah, pop it around as normal.
Yeah. Just give it a little nip up. Right, okay. So I bring this in, is it?
Yeah,
so
you bring it in. It's very intuitive.
Okay. I'll go slow for the first time.
Okay.
I pull that. Right, so it grabs it there.
Grab it. Watch it. Okay. So let's have a little look at what you've left me now to catch me finger on.
Okay. Oh, that's a very clean end.
I should be wearing gloves possibly, but look how smooth that is, Gordon.
Let's have a look. It moves up a bit. So okay.
Because we haven't set the tensile strength. Let's have a look at the bit of kit. There you go.
So I'll dial this up a little bit.
Okay.
So this is
so you're moving it away from one. That was at 3 kg. What are you going to set it to now?
I'll go to 2.5 just to be a bit awkward on the numbers.
Okay. Right. Okay. Let's try it again then.
So I'll bring it around.
Yeah.
Fasten it in.
Yeah. In your own time. Okay. So pull that one up. Yep. So let's see it. I'm getting excited now that we all like this.
Shaking with excitement here.
Here we go. Just give it a little pull.
I didn't have it in properly.
No, you didn't. Huh? There's a joke there and I left it. Okay, let's have another look.
Nice clean end.
And that doesn't move now.
And that doesn't move. All right,
okay, give it a little pull.
No, it doesn't. So yeah, so just that slight adjustment on that dial. I quite like that.
Yeah, so let's think of the bigger picture then. So perhaps we've got cables here, we've got some data cables. We're bundling these data cables down, maybe we're on a basket, and we've got pull, and you know, we've all done it before, haven't we? We've pulled a cable tie that hard that it snaps, and you'll throw it away and go, probably inexpensive cable tie would be thrown out as a statement. Yeah. It's not.
And let's get there, I think the tensile strength on the packet isn't a challenge.
No,
it
isn't.
That's the maximum, that's the point it will snap. And I bet that guy we met in Doncaster last year who did an impressive result on the challenge wall, but he's ripping cable ties to bits every day.
Yeah. And so when we use it, and we've done it on data, and we had a little experiment before we started this, is actually that when you start pulling it tighter and tighter and tighter, you actually start denting and reforming the cables of which you're trying to support, in this case, to a basket.
So you're saying you can go too far?
You can, but it won't necessarily break the cable tie, but you look at the effect on the actual conductors itself. So if you start, you've gone back to one. Right, okay, so we're going to take these white ones here.
Yep, I'll have a go.
Okay, so we set it at, which is 3 kg of tensile strength. Okay. And we'll see how that one goes when you get it on. So, cable tie, just pop it around as normal. Okay, and just pull it up then with the tool in a minute. Right, okay.
Right, so I'll do the first one.
Well, let me bring the camera in, so if we get too excited again. So slide it in, see if you can do it right this time. Ah, there you go, you're in with a chance. Okay, right. So we know it's going to have a clean cut, so rub your finger across it.
And that's gripped it pretty well, so I'd be quite happy with that. Yeah, and it's nice and, look, there's no blood.
No, okay. So that's at 3 kg of tensile strength.
Yeah.
Well, let's do it in numbers that I can work with. Let's go for 2 next. Okay.
Today on Sesame Street, that's the number 2.
Okay.
So I've dialed that up to 2.
Right, okay, another cable tie.
Okay, that's all right.
And we'll see the effect now we have on this bundle of, is it Cat 6 cables?
It is Cat 6 cables. Okay, yeah. So we'll feature these in our networking video, a bit of leftovers from that. If you haven't seen that series, it's doing impeccably well at the moment.
Yeah, some good videos in there, some good tools in that one as well. So we expect to get it. You're in the right position.
Yeah.
Yeah, ready. Pull it up. Okay, so lovely clean cut again. But now look at the conductors, Gordon. Look at the one on the top.
Yeah, so that's you see it's
squashed down. Now, they're not here, okay? So we've added, now we're at a 6 kg of tensile strength. Mm. Let's go to 3 now. Okay, so what we're trying to replicate here is how hard maybe an electrician is pulling these cable ties in order to secure them to a basket or a tray.
Yeah, I mean, I think, obviously, Pheonix Contact live in that panel building world. We've looked at the crimp fox on the channel before, which was a 4-in-1 tool for doing those ferrules. You know, we love a ferrule. But yeah, this
is now 11 kg.
Right.
All right, okay, so let's see, first of all, whether the tie wrap can cope.
Yeah,
so there you go. Oh, you saw that pull them conductors. Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah. that's really biting into the...
Just rotate around a little bit for us. Yeah, look at that one there. That is really, really squashed now. But the cable tie can do that, so it's within the parameters of the cable tie, but I would suggest it's not doing any favours to the conductors themselves. Let's go all in on a 4.
Take it to 4.
This is 15 kg now.
Okay, so do that.
Okay.
Let's put the tie around.
So this is probably first thing on a Monday morning after a restful weekend pull.
Okay. A week of X.
Absolutely, maybe 3. So I'll give that a pull. Oh, now we're at the...
Okay.
Okay. So what's happened there then, Gordon?
It's gone beyond the tensile strength of the cable tie itself. So,
Yeah. So we've got a set of metal cable ties down here. They make a tool also for that, don't they, Gordon?
Yes, they do. So that's the that's the UNIFOX CTM 7,9.
Okay.
So that will work up to 7.9 millimeter width steel cable ties with a point. 3 millimeter thickness,
yeah.
Whereas this version we've got here, the UNIFOX CT4,8,
catchy number.
A P. We don't know what the P means.
Okay,
but that will handle up to 4.8 millimeter wide. Plastic.
I was going to go for plastic.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh dear. So you just jumped in there a bit before me, didn't you? So of course it goes on the width of the tie wrap and the thickness of the cable tie, whichever you want.
So this will do up to 1.6 millimetres.
Yeah.
Again, so just remember, you know, Pheonix Contact, the normal world they live in is the world of the panel builder.
Yes.
So obviously people are going to say, does it do the massive cable ties? No, it's probably not, this one's not designed for that, and that's not the world that necessarily Pheonix Contact
lives. And you can see yourself, can't you, clearly sitting in that panel, just zipping them up, haven't you? So, and they're going to be in very short proximity to each other, maybe as you're bundling them in a panel.
Yeah, perhaps you're taking that bundle out to the control switches on the door or something like that. But yeah, that's a...
super clean cut, which is what I like.
Yeah.
But it just shows you, doesn't it? I would imagine electricians are probably a little bit like me. You probably haven't looked at a packet of cable ties and looked for that tensile strength and then worked out its limits. But this tool here will show you when you've gone beyond the limit and you can actually see the damage that you're doing to those conductors.
You can see it there, so I can't slide that one up.
Shall we have a little closer look?
It's bundled. I can slide it if I pull it really hard, but it hasn't damaged the... You know, you can just see where it's gone into the outer jacket.
Let's have a look at the
these ones in there. They haven't gone anywhere, but it's... Yes, and then this one here is... Yeah.
Properly squashed them down, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Just because the cable tie can do it doesn't mean it's a good idea, does it?
Yeah. But not nice. I like that. I think...
Yeah. So... We like bringing tools to the channel, not just necessarily the run-of-the-mill tools that we've seen on the channel, but these ones here that are specialist tools, they have an application probably for panel wiring, etc. Or if you're doing a lot of data cables, I think it would be a good idea. But it's that clean cut and leaving behind a job that obviously isn't going to cause me any grief in the future. It looks like I've followed you around on a few jobs with all those razor-sharp cuts on your cable ties. As always, we're interested in your comments. Is this something that you might consider buying in the future? Maybe you've got one at the moment and you get on really well with it, and you can tell us other applications that you've been using it for. Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.